profession. Raymond Lisenba was always a man of very average or even below par intelligence. He was described by a childhood neighbour as less than a half-wit and was never too successful in the world of academics. Yet he had some sort of charm to him that meant he was quite successful in finding marriage alliances. His first marriage was in 1921 when he married a woman named Maud Duncan, who ended up divorcing him on account of the fact that he demanded too kinky and sadistic sex. After this incident, somewhere between 1924 and 25, he is believed to have changed his name to Robert S. James. Mr. James, with his new identity, moved to Kansas and married a second time, but he apparently cheated on her because she ditched him when he was threatened by a man who was the father of a pregnant young woman, allegedly impregnated by James. This is when he moved out further to North Dakota. His mother died and left him a handsome amount in life insurance money. This made him greedy and introduced him to the idea of insurance fraud. This would become a habit that would lead him down the path of many murders and his eventual arrest. Inspired by the possibilities of life insurance fraud, he brought a policy for his nephew with himself as a nominee. A few weeks following the purchase of the life insurance, he created circumstances that would lead to his nephew's death in a car accident by tampering with the car. With his foolproof plan, he is believed to have even telegrammed his sister about her son's death, even before the actual death. In 1932, he was yet again able to charm another young woman into marrying him, this time a woman named Winona Wallace. Soon after the marriage, he convinced her to buy life insurance in the amount of $14,000 and ensured he was the sole beneficiary. As soon as she had the insurance, her death was only a matter of time. On their honeymoon in Colorado, he had his opportunity. He hit his wife with a hammer on her head and then drove her car off of a cliff. He claimed it to be an accident and that he was able to jump out of the car before it fell off the cliff. However, much to his dismay, Winona survived, yet she had no memory of the incident, probably from the trauma of the hammer to her head or the fall off of the cliff. Robert murdered Mary by slitting her throat and then putting a bullet in the back of her head. Then he moved on to his children, whose lives he ended by slitting their throats from ear to ear. At 8:42 a.m., neighbours of the Fishers woke to a thundering boom. The Fisher house had exploded and gone up in flames, creating such a concussion that the explosion was felt up to almost half a mile away. The large explosion was followed by several smaller explosions, which were believed to have been caused by the presence of firearm ammunition or paint cans in the house. During the investigation, the police discovered that a gas line had been pulled out of the furnace at the back of the house to hide evidence, and the flame from a lit candle sparked the explosion. When firefighters were finally demolished the place. The bodies of a woman and two children were found inside, incinerated. Mary, 38, Brittany, 12, and Bobby, 10, were dead. Robert William Fisher, on the other hand, was nowhere to be found. Investigators say Robert is the lone suspect in the case, and they believe he had a 10-hour window to escape. The planning for his fifth wife's murder was a bit more elaborate. He was smart enough to